Hello, I'm very happy to be here, at least virtually, and to be able to present to you our advanced technologies for viral vector production. With the current success of gene therapy, there is associated an increasing demand for viral vector manufacturing, and that is in particularly true for adenoviral vectors and for adeno-associated AAV vectors. And for adenovirus, in particular due to the pandemic and the vaccines that have been developed, we see an increasing significance for adenoviral vectors for vaccination. And the production methods for these vectors have been well established over many years. They are mainly based on HEK293 cells, human embryonic kidney cells, and this method yields very good vector productivities and good quality, but they have an inherent risk. And the inherent risk is that when the HEK293 cells were produced, a big piece of Ad5 genomic DNA was used to immortalize these cells. And this now means that in the HEK293 genome, there is a long stretch of adenovirus DNA leading to two homology arms flanking the gene of interest in the E1 deleted adenoviral vector. And this can lead to double crossovers and associated with that homologous recombination, which then replaces the deleted E1 gene in the vector, leading to RCA, replication competent adenovirus. This is, of course, a very undesired event, and it's rare, but it still occurs and can cause significant problems with bad releases for the vectors. We at CEVEC have, when we designed our cell platform, taken care of this issue, and our CAP cells, which is also human cell line, have been specifically designed to mitigate this risk. We've done that by designing the Ad5 sequences that we use to immortalize the cells, leading to only one small stretch of homology that does not flank the GOI, but is only at the 3' end. And this then really minimizes the risk of RCA formation. And we have proven that, and our partners have seen that in many different production batches, also for different RCA-free vector productions. The CAP cells are a good host for adenoviral vector production for a number of reasons. And the most important reason, the design of the genetic makeup I just explained to you, but they're also a human cell line of non-tumor origin. They do show very robust growth at high cell densities in suspension. They grow in a number of commercially available animal component-free chemically defined media. We have scaled them to many different formats of bioreactors. The cell line history is fully documented, as are the materials that have been used to make the cells. And we have a biologics master file deposited with the FDA that can be cross-referenced. And the first CAP-derived viral vectors are now in clinical trials. There's also a GMP master cell bank ready for use for early stages of your project. Let me switch gears now and talk to you about our Elevector platform for adeno-associated virus. So when we look at in vivo gene therapy, then really AAV becomes the predominant vector form. And with the products that are currently in the market, production of the vectors has not been the major issue. These targets, like Luxturna's or Zolgensma, they target rare diseases and are administered at relatively low doses to the patient, meaning that the VG that are required per year for a marketed product are in the range of 10 to the 12th to 10 to the 13th. This means that the classical production method, as it was developed at the universities where the therapies were invented, can still be used to generate market material. That scenario drastically changes when we look at a lot of the new indications for which clinical trials are now starting, and some of them really target very common diseases like Parkinson's or Alzheimer's. And in many cases, there will also have to be a lot higher doses to be applied to the patient. This leads to, or can lead to, a million-fold increase in the yearly demand of product. And of course, here, a scalable process is desperately required. We are addressing this issue with our Edvector platform, which relies on true stable producer cell lines. That means no further plasma transfection is required for production, and we do not need a helper virus to start the production. It's a fully stable cell line with all components integrated, like you know it from monoclonal antibodies. These cells are then banked as a GMP cell bank, expanded to the production volume, and production is induced in the large-scale bioreactor. Of course, for AAV, for each product, there are specific components. One specific component is the capsid, and the other specific component, of course, is the gene of interest, the therapeutic gene. So what we have done is we have established an alpha cell line. That alpha cell line carries all other components required, namely rep and adenoviral helper genes, both inducible. And these cells have been extensively characterized and banked. And for each specific project, we now bring in the specific serotype-specific capsid and the therapeutic gene to generate the full producer cell line. To show you an example of such a producer cell line generation, so in this case, we've used the GFP for convenience as gene of interest. I've generated a polyclonal producer pool that was polyclonal for capsid and GFP. From there, gone to single cell cloning and screening using an MBO15 Stoltenberg bioreactor system. And the pool already shows decent titers, 10 to the 13th VG per liter in the number as well as in 10 liter format. In the single cell clones here with a moderate number of single cell clones screened, we easily increase that productivity in a batch process in the 10 liter bioreactor. To 14th VG. The next question is, can you really scale it up? And we found you can easily, so we could, without problems, transition from the 15 ml ember to the 10 liter. And from the 10 liter, we work onwards for further upscaling. We work in collaboration with Paul, who then did the upscaling. Allegro 50 liter and then 200 liter. And as you can see here, the cell was very reproducible in these bioreactors. And also the original titers seen in our 10 liter process were also very reproducible in two different runs in both of the format each. One of the advantages of fully stable cell line, of course, is that you can do process intensification. And that's what we did as a next step. So we looked at perfusion process using an ATF perfusion. And to our surprise, we found that the productivity was not just maintained with higher cell densities, but it actually increased. So we saw, we worked with four times higher cell densities here, but we still saw a 30-fold increase in titers. So we reached up to 3 times 10 to the 15th VG per liter, which basically means an about 10-fold higher cell-specific productivity in these cells. And as you can imagine, we keep optimizing that system. What we also found surprisingly is that the number of full particle increases. So in two independent perfusion runs, we ended up with 30 to 40% full viral particles, just in crude harvest, so no enrichment, no purification at that stage. We're quite happy with the platform. You can imagine we keep optimizing processes and cell line development. The other thing we've done is we're now duplicating the platform in 2 and 3 cells. So we started with our CAP cells, of which we knew to be good adenoviral producers, but we get a lot of requests for doing Elevector cells on 293 background. So that's what we started implementing. The first step, we took an adherently growing ATCC293 cell line, adapted that to suspension growth, and single cell cloned the cells. And just to see if they're really suitable for AAV production, we tested them for transient, just standard triple transfection, transient AAV production. And as you can see, and we're comparing to two well-known and well-used competitor HEK cell lines here, our CEVEC 293 cells easily match those in titers and also in percent of free capsid in a triple transfection system. And also when we look at the potency of the AAV vectors, we see similar potencies, if not even slightly better potencies. So everything set to generate any vector cells on our 293 cells. And we did that by obviously starting with alpha cells, so again, carrying rapid helper genes. And as a proof of concept, we then introduced an AAV8 capsid plus a gene of interest. And in this case, it's a GFP luciferase fusion, which has about 4.3 kb, so approaching the packaging capacity of the AAV vectors. And we haven't gone to the single cell clone level yet, that's ongoing work, but when we just looked at different pool fractions, we found that, and this is just a standard batch process, we could easily reach 10 to the 10th VG per mil. So this is a different scale now. So this is, we're talking 10 to the 13th VG per liter, and also up to 15% full cells. And remember, this is polyclonal producer cells. So they're polyclonal for the capsid and for the gene of interest. So I can't wait to see the single cell data. What we feel is that the HEK cells should be performing at least as well as the cap-derived vector cells. So how are we working with our clients and partners? So what we're doing is we're not developing own products, but we're really offering our technology platforms. So basically, we do the cell line development for vector producer cells, and we also offer our unmodified cap cells for AAV production, including aliquots of the GMP cell bank in this case. And in addition to the cell line development services, what we do is then tech transfer for the cell line, for the cell line handling, the upstream process, and our clients can then use these cells under a license to the vector technology or to the cap cells. We have ongoing collaborations, and some that are in the public domain are Roche and Spark and Biogen. And with this, I'd like to close and thank you for your interest.